What are you at? It is Electrics, and this is Nevermind, a game where you are a doctor and you're going inside somebody's mind. Call it a mindscape. And basically, you're going in there and you're gonna try and fix the broken ass problem. Well, the amount of problems is just ridiculous. But when you go in there, it also mixes with your mind, so then you've got those problems to deal with. So you've got two minds in one mind, which is called a mindscape, and you have to figure out the differences between those minds, and then you have to fix the problem in the mind that you were in. Holy crap! It is a really intense game. I was streaming it tonight, and I just wanted to make... You know what, man? I want to see if I can make this series, you know, do the whole thing. Let's play it. If you like the video, give it a like, and I'll play some more of it. So if I see, like, 5 likes, I'll keep going. But if not, then that is that. Yes, begin! I want to be, and the reason, one of the reasons why I want to play it, is it's so beautiful! It's so awesome! Did you hear that music? Don't think you did, but at least if you're on the stream, you definitely didn't. How to make yourself look like a complete and utter moron. Stream with no sand. Oh, hey. And she's just so beautiful, but everybody's just absolutely amazing. You're just absolutely all beautiful people. And I really congratulate you, you know, for being so beautiful, for being so genetically superior in every way to all the people on Earth. My, my, my. I can't believe you're in this awesome genetical institute, boy. Hello, doctor. Our facial recognition sensors detect that you must be Neurostalgia's newest neuroprober. Oh, yeah, girl.
Let me probe you.
Welcome to the team. Creepy voice. That was so creepy. We can take care of the final registration details here. Press continue and continue the process. We appreciate you arriving extra early today. We find it helps to onboard new neuroprobers before colleagues arrive. Because then the whole cross-probulation would just get too intense. We couldn't handle all that probing. That's too much probing. As a neuroprober, you will be delving into the subconscious mind of our clients to help them work through their struggles and psychological trauma. It's a deeply important work, but, you know, that requires a great deal of security and, of course, absolute discretion. We will now proceed and verify your identity. Oh, how will you do that? Will you check my piss or something? The experience ahead will contain intense scenes, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, you warned me already before. Well, let's pick an absolute classic. Nostalgia. Ass. Continue. Yes. We see you come wearing your assigned nostalgia device. Thank you for your compliance with our standard policy. You may notice tips and points of interaction within the institute will be highlighted by the lens. Your first day of registration is complete. Please proceed to the staff area behind you. Your nostalgia device, aka Google Glass, has been synced to our employee account, and you're gonna go into all the inner workings and absolutely restricted areas. Because that's what nostalgia does. It lets you do and go wherever you want, and then take videos of people in the bathroom. Don't assume my gender! I can go in whatever bathroom I want! I don't care if I'm handicapped. I can go pee in the normal people's bathroom. I mean, normal people's stalls. If I
could work in a place like this, I would be happy. If they even have something even close to this. When I went to college, there was a wall. And it was like a tropical rainforest. They fired water at it. Not like fired, but they misted water on it. And it was a complete wall just of like different tropical plants. And when you go there, it's like 4 degrees cooler than anywhere else in the entire college. And it's just, it's so pretty and it's calming. You just want to sit there on your awesome little bench and just breathe it all in. Breathe in the absolute serenity that is that wall. Feel the furry wall, baby! Even the most complicated knots need a hand to untie themselves. Okay, I'm just gonna take a seat, baby, 'cause I own this office. The Neurostalgia Institute. Dear Dr. Ass, let us be the first to warmly welcome you to the Nostalgia Institute. This room is your office, and we trust that you will find everything you need. And everything you need will be comfortably working here. Your nostalgia device, I totally wrecked that, will log you into your most primary computer just across from the desk. You can get started there whenever you feel ready. Whenever you feel comfortable, I'm here to talk. Once again, welcome to our small elite team of neuroprobers. And let's get a probing, baby! Oh, I'm ready to probe, don't you worry about that. That's the only reason I took this job. From the very beginning, I had an absolute passion to probe things. I had an absolute, just a fire within my belly that, you know, it was kind of like intuition. It told me I had to probe. That's what I had to be when I grew up. A prober. Client intro sim. Being seen by Dr. S. A simulated mind scope constructed by Neurostalgia to help with new employee orientation. Percentage imprint 0% explored. Well, let's activate that. Oh, yeah! I love how it's just a room.
Scotty, I am now entering the holodeck.
Even though you have nothing to do with the holodeck. That's where I'm going. With the engines at 110%, we're not going to be able to run the holodeck. But Captain, we're already running at 120%. Wait, Scotty, why do you sound Indian? I don't get it. You're Scottish. That's why your name's Scotty. The intro sim is a simulated mindscape created by the Neurostalgia Institute to ensure neuroprobes are fully prepared before working on the first client.
Things
Although, not as
almost
complex.
Unbearable for me. And for my family. Nothing has helped. I guess that's why I'm here. So, if I just talk about my troubles, you'll be able to use it later to help with the...
Procedure. Kiss my ass.
Seems hard to believe, but you're the expert. I think many of my issues started when I was young. So...
You're sinking?
Why don't we start with my childhood days, yes?
Are you heavy?
Okay. Let's see.
Heavier than the average bear, I guess.
I was raised in a lovely cottage in rural Germany. We didn't have much, but my twin sister, got by. There was actually a
man. I wish I had his accent.
Early childhood, and often.
And that is why we ate that shit. Every time I do that, I didn't even press anything. I was just sitting here nonchalantly enjoying. His awesome
Welcome
German voice and his awesome accent.
I am pleased to be your guide. When I'm speaking, you can always make a right-click motion to skip this instruction.
Whether oh, you can probe me anytime.
Whether client directly or neuroprobing within their mind, it is always imperative to listen.
Yay!
You'll find
What's
that
up, Brad?
Woo!
I'm having a seizure all day long.
In the case of our clients, it's often the forgotten story of the trauma they experienced. Some parts of the patient's memory may have become confused or corrupted.
He had a famine most of his early childhood life.
Or cover up the truth of what happened to them. However, if you look carefully in the right places, you will find that the truth will ultimately shine through.
You can't handle the truth! Dear brats, go away, love your stepmom. Wow, what a bitch. Can't believe she would say that to her awesome
While
stepkids. I mean, I'm just an absolute gem.
Like photographs. This is how your consciousness interprets the concrete memory moments it finds within the client's psyche. Typically, there are about 10 of these memory photos found in each psyche.
Oh, I just want cake. Hold on to I'm so hungry. So much.
When you acknowledge a memory photo, it will surface more prominently in the client's psyche, and at that point can be found in a safe area of the mind, often where you begin within the client's
only in mind. The safe place.
When you have found all 10 photos, you must put 5 of the memories that actually represent the trauma in the proper order. Doing so will, at last, fully release the memory to the client's conscious mind. Often, he or she will experience a breakthrough at this moment. That breakthrough is what every neural prober lives for, and is the key to the client finally being able to work towards...
Because then you can break through their
security walls
and begin to really delve deep into the probing process. That's really the only way.
It's what I was born to do.
Oh, flowers, aren't they so pretty? They fill my lungs with determination.
And acknowledge these photos. However, this is easy.
Oh, I can skip her. Oh, I didn't notice. A lot of the times I find she says stuff that I don't really need to hear. Like when I play a game, I would rather just the music play and not have a whole lot of tutorial.
Interacting with one part of the mind can sometimes open up new areas of the psyche. Some things, like these doors.
There are some things which are really helpful, like she telling me that I would have to combine the images in order to make
my sister save me from becoming dinner.
Oh, thank you, Sev. You're the best.
And we'll take every opportunity to feed off of any sensation.
Oh no, is it gonna hurt me?
Or tension you
please
offer.
No!
If you can, try to stay calm and peaceful.
Follow the breadcrumbs.
If you can calm yourself, you'll find the
don't even worry about it, girl. I am the picture of serenity.
Some details of a given trauma can be especially
it's buried behind.
But by gently and cleverly
birds.
Listening to the clues the mind gives you, you will find all you need.
That's where I bury my secrets, right
just
behind my bird.
A puzzle
there
for
we
you
go.
To solve. When you focus on
woo!
The clues, you a right-click motion
woo!
To break your concentration.
Woo! Give me that picture. That's mine. You can't have it.
Hey, why don't you stop being selfish, you son of a bitch? All we want is, you know, pictures and stuff. That's, we're birds. We love to look at pictures. So,
follow the breadcrumbs.
I can't believe I'm strolling through this beautiful forest.
In search! What I'm in search for, I really don't know. I'm in search for pictures. What do you think you're doing? Think you're gonna karate chop me? You think you're gonna jump down from above? And swiftly break my neck? You think you're a ninja?
I don't think so. You're not a ninja. You don't have the grits.
You don't have the... Why don't you grow... Hey, what? They're falling. It's raining babies. Oh, yeah, it really is. And they squeak, too.
I like squeaky babies.
Squeaky babies are my favorite kind of babies.
Squeak for me!
Wait, that was weird. A terrible fire burned our home down.
Oh, no. Don't tell me that.
While neuroprobing,
that is so
your consciousness
sad.
Is lost deep inside the subconscious mind of the client. While this is a journey that you must make alone, we at the Neurostalgia Institute take the safety of our neuroprobers very seriously. If you need to access
oh, yeah?
any of your neuroprobers,
do we use protection?
Screen, press your finger where an escape key might be. This will bring up your neuroprober tools, and you can proceed as needed from there.
So we have neuroprober condoms, I assume. I mean, I want to have safe probation... Probe... to probe contact. I don't want to mess around with none of that dirty stuff.
Oh, no, I'm just a poor, young, lonely, supple young lady who has lost her way. Can anybody tell me how to get to the exit? My name is Dr. Ass.
Oh, who stabbed you, baby? Oh, and you have no eyes.
That's a sad story. My eyes are my favorite and most beautiful feature. So it makes me very sad that you have none. Oh, I just missed the pathway.
Walking through the forest, yeah. With my awesome feet. They're so big and big and beautiful. They just step all over the road like it's a peasant. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God, let's see if you can picture together this glamorous and fabulous story from what we have now received.
My stepmother had a twin sister that hated me. Oh, no, no, that's a sad story. I can't believe you would tell me those really deep and personal thoughts. Are you one of those type of people that just wants to cement the
some especially vulnerable areas
shut up.
Can be very when you place you must be
She talks a lot, man. She talks more than me. I can't. That bitch. She needs to be quiet for a minute.
Amaget roses by another name. They would never smell so red.
Just running while somebody's in. Who's in the bushes? Probably a squirrel or something. Who cares? Sounds small. What? Gerald! You're so goddamn fat you can't get off of your chair and walk one step, like literally one step, to pick up a piece of bread. Are you shitting me? Gerald, seriously, you gotta go to the gym, man. Like, you've got problems. Yeah, there you go. Selfish bastard. Last night, you made me get out of the couch just to get you a beer. Told me to stand up. I was worried, man. Why did you make me do... Why, Gerald, are you so lazy? I am going to kick your ass. It's probably Gerald behind me right now.
And hello there,
G.
Bow, 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 bow. Bow, 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 bow.
Let's have a rock concert. What do you think I am? The guy from Charlie Brown?
Hey, my guy played a tiny piano. I hate pianos. Just kidding. I love pianos. Pianos are my favorite.
Hey-yo. You're looking good, but I don't have any time to talk. I've got places to be. I've got important business matters to deal with. They're apparently over here. Hey, yo. Is every single person in this game just a lazy, fat piece of shit made out of stone? Are you really even made of stone? I think you're just faking it. You're just pretending you're made out of stone, so I'll bring you biscuits. And buns. But I ain't gonna butter them for you. I'll bring them. I'm not gonna butter them, though. No. It's no way. My best friend. Hey! Who's throwing baby heads around here? And why are they... It was you! Sarah Squirrel.
Oh! Come on, come with me. I'm gonna give you to Sarah. She needs a present. Her life's been pretty depressing since the light went out.
It was her last source of happiness.
And then the snow fell. Will you seriously shut up? Dude, I'm trying to walk here. Trying to find my way. I can't do it while I'm all distracted by your extremely... Oh no, they killed Ronnie! Ronnie, RIP 2016 too soon. Give me that bread. Give me that.
It was you, wasn't it, Freddy Frugus? Yeah, well, I can't continue without giving you this piece of bread, you selfish bastard. I can't believe you would kill that
poor, helpless squirrel.
And now... Just call in the next 5 minutes, and you'll get A bunch of free wood stoves. That's right, your hands will be so warm. So warm, you'll have to chop them off. You won't even know what to do with your hands. You won't be able to put them in your gloves, that is for sure, because they'll burn the gloves. Yeah, they'll burn those gloves right off, man. Give me that. House was a trap. Oh, shit. Don't tell me that. You're scaring me. Don't tell me that was a trap. Bro, what the hell? Oh, that is huge, man.
It's bigger than my dick.
What's... Hey!
Help us!
Well, I'm sorry. I'm a little too late. And, if you call right now, in the next five... the next 3 minutes, you'll get some giant-ass burning cages. You never know when you might need one, but they're there when you do.
Oh no, he lost his leg.
What happened to your leg? I'll find it. I'm on a mission for my baby's legs.
I'm on a mission for my baby's legs. I know they're around here. I know they're around here. And I don't want my baby to lose her legs, cause she is so beautiful. And I want her to be a dancer when she grows up. And there's no way she's ever gonna howl and dance if she doesn't have any legs. Well, there doesn't appear to be anything else in this death-lit area. Full of giant burning cages. Oh, hello. Sorry, no. I have not found your leg yet, but I will notify you as soon as I do. Oh no, he doesn't want help! He's an independent skeleton. He has hopes. He has dreams. He's got wants, he's got needs. He doesn't need my help. He just wants a lady.
A beautiful, beautiful lady to help with some complex calculations in the bedroom area.
Hey, yo, why are you trying to give yourself a fist bump? That's kind of lonely, man. That's actually,
it's kind of cringy, bro. Don't do that. Kind of cringy, bro.
Oh, well, it doesn't matter. I'll let you do you. You just do whatever. You're an adult. You can do whatever you want. You can consent to whatever you want to consent to. Oh, yay. Do I make it? Don't even. Don't do it. My. This is quite the long bridge. I wonder where it leads. Somewhere cool, I hope. Maybe there'll be like Lamborghinis at the end and like candy!
Hey, my guy, candy. Candy, gimme. Oh, yes.
This is better than I ever gonna vote for.
Your psyches will inevitably
seriously?
Intermingle.
What is
just
that?
Just as the client's mind can affect you, you will see parts of yourself reflected in the mind of the client. Tread
God damn it.
And
oh, it's happy to see me. I'm happy to see you, too, when you're in my stomach. Okay, let's get the hell out of here. This place is starting to creep me.
The fuck out! Is that a puppy? No! Is that a puppy?
It's not, there's no way it's a puppy. Nope. I could not stand it if that was a puppy. I would cry. Is that a face? He's sticking his tongue out of me. He's so happy, so content. What is with all the skin, anyway? There's so much skin around here. It's kind of gross, actually. Ooh. Too much skin, man. Get a shirt on or something. Penis mushrooms. Hey.
Why so many penis mushrooms?
No, Jared! Too young.
He was too young. He didn't live a full life.
What will his baby owlets do without him? My god. Ouch. That hurts.
That poor tree!
It's got knives, like, sticking around.
At Neurostalgia, we take great measures to ensure our neuroprobe. However, if when you're ready.
More like great measures to creep me the fuck out!
But it just looks so absolutely delectable.
and oozy. Yeah. Come on, buddy. I'ma get you out of here! Yeah. Shit. Yeah, this is exactly what I wanted to happen. Thank you. Thank you, Bones. D1. See the pattern. There has to be a pattern. There's always a pattern in these games. Yeah! Look at me go! I'm the man! Shit. Fucked up big time that time. Gotcha! A beautiful strawberry pie. My favorite pie is strawberry pie. No, it's apple pie. No, it's pumpkin pie. I don't know what pie my favorite pie is, but I like lots of pie. Ah! Oh, this isn't that bad. We're just going to Narnia. Oh, what's up? Man, I missed. I want one more high five. Yeah, bro! Oh, shit, I missed again. I feel like I have to get their hand. I don't know why. What am I doing here? Come on. All right. Come on. I got this one. Ah! Yes! Okie dokie.
The boat to freedom!
Oh, hi, Sarah. You made it to the end. What's up, Ronnie? How are the kids, boy? What's up, Gerald, bro? Put her there. Ring that bell, son. Ring it. Freddy Frugal. You son of a bitch. I'll never forgive you for what you did.
You killed all those helpless forest animals.
You monster! Okay, let's just get out of this land of complete crazy. Let's just get the hell right out of here, back out into the sunlight. Hey, what up?
My name is Marcel, and my mother is a name that I cannot tell you because my mother is an absolute saint. And she needs to introduce herself to me. Marcel! Marcel! Come in for dinner! No, mother, I don't feel like it. Marcel! Come in for dinner! But mother, I'm a piano. I've never eaten in my life. I'm a piano. Marcel, do you want me to spank you, Marcel? Mother, I'm a piano. Where would you even spank me? I don't, mother. Marcel, if you don't come in here right now, I'm going to kick your ass.
Okay, what do we got? It's obviously the story of Hansel and Gretel. And I have to put the five images that represent the story right in there. So, let's try this. My stepmother aided my twin sister and me.
Boop!
House was a trap? No way. She would take us to the forest and leave us on the trail to find out. Yes, hell yeah. That is definitely the next one. Put you right there. I was bitten by an animal in my sleep. Pretty sure that was me. Worst birthday ever? Again, I'm a loser. It was me. Now, let's see. My sister saved me from becoming dinner. No. Terrible fire. Huh, I wonder what it could be. Wait, is there a house one? Yeah, we were lost and we found a house that looked real nice. It looked super fantastic.
I feel fantastic. I feel fantastic.
Okay, there's one. Let me see. My stepmother. Okay. The house is a trap. Children would be cooked and eaten there. Yeah, 100%. And the winner is This one, I want to say.
I'm ascending to godhood!
Take me, Jesus!
Oh my God.
I am now one of you.
It's all rushing.
I know the face of my demons.
It's so awful, and
it's like my whole life.
I don't want to remember, but yes.
Flash before my eyes.
The face of my demon. My sister and I, we were taken out into the woods by my stepmother for one of her nighttime walks.
What does he look like?
Usually find out
is your demon sexy?
Trail of whatever we could grab before the walk. Marbles,
breadcrumbs,
or even pebbles. However, one night, she took us deep, deep into the woods.
With a deer that only had one antler!
Leave a trail of crumbs.
Horrifying.
All the forest creatures must have eaten them. We were lost, so
yeah,
lost.
They're probably hungry.
We tried to find our way back.
Maybe you should brought
so dark,
rocks.
We were in the very
anything else? That was the
woods.
Dumbest.
We were lost
what?
For days, hungry and tired. We finally found a house and were so hopeful that someone might.
I love his accent. Oh, that tired.
That house was no order.
It was full, man.
It looked like
I would have ate that entire house.
Something
I would have sat there.
Off. About it. We shouldn't have gone in.
Watch Netflix.
We did. It was
I would have dummied the whole thing.
For lost children like us. There was a woman in the house who would fatten her prisoners up and try to eat them.
She would force feed us candy.
It was going to be our fate.
It was exactly like my grandmother.
I was first. She tricked me into getting close to the oven, and before I knew it.
Oh, that was the stove.
If it weren't for my clever sister, Gretel, pulling me out in time, I would have been burned.
Gretel?
Alive. We escaped our house and found our way home. After that,
But your stepmother sucks.
Our awful stepmother passed away, and my family came into some wealth.
Yeah, things got really good. My mother, she died. We came into wealth, too.
We just forgot.
It's pretty sweet, isn't it?
Events. I mean, how could you live with those images and memories inside your mind? Then again, they were
a house of candy. How could I live with that? Oh no!
Beyond memory, beyond time. However, I can now confront my past, confront this trauma.
It's all about healing, Hansel.
It is better to know than not.
Heal yourself.
Okay. It seems like Hansel had a really traumatic experience when he was younger. It really scarred him. He was force-fed candy by his grandma. And apparently, he has that confused with a demonic experience. Hey, who's there? Is that the old lady? Oh, it's just butterflies. I love butterflies. So pretty. Well, that'll do it for the first episode. If you did like this, give it a like and let me know what you thought of it if you want me to continue. Because I think I like this game. Sneewitchin told me to play it. She actually gave me the money for it too, which was awesome. And it's really turning out to be a really awesome game. It's just mint, man. Just mint. The graphics are mint. The gameplay is mint, the story is mint, it's very original too, which is one thing I like about it, and one of the reasons I want to keep playing it. It's a very original horror game, it's kind of psychological, I guess you could say. Well, this is Electrics.